In this video, I'm going to show you how you can make use of your project files, like A2L and a binary file, as well as calibration data files, directly in EHANDBOOK Navigator. EHANDBOOK Navigator already knows a lot about your labels. So, for example, when you click on a label, it can explain what the label means, as well as show you the ECU functions which write or read the signal. However, for understanding ECU functions, it is often required to also have the calibration data for the labels available. So how can EHANDBOOK support you in those cases? You can load additional information and data from your calibration files into EHANDBOOK Navigator and make use of that in the label pop-up. Go to Data, Measurement and Calibration Files and then start selecting your A2L file. After the A2L file is loaded, you can simply click on the labels, which will populate the label pop-up. And here you can see additional information, which is now fetched from your A2L file. The basic information that EHANDBOOK Navigator shows here in the label pop-up is the display identifier, limit, and unit, which is now being fetched from the A2L file. If you want to know more information, simply expand the label pop-up dialog, clicking on the More button. Through this, you can get additional information about any kinds of labels like maps, curves, and signals. But what about calibration data now? So let's load additional calibration data files. Go to Data, Measurement and Calibration Files, and load your binary file. In my case, it's a hex file. After loading now the binaries, you can also click on calibration parameters and inspect the actual calibration parameter value directly in place. Use the buttons to switch between different value representations from physical to binary, decimal, or hexadecimal, depending on the format that you like to read the value. For curves, the label pop-up dialog shows a graphical rendition of the curve data, as well as a tabular form. You can switch to an enlarged graphical visualization using the More button. In the same way, the calibration data for maps is being visualized. Besides calibration data from your project files, you can also load a DCM, CDF, or PACO file, for example, exported from Inca. So let's load an additional calibration data file in DCM format. When you now click on a label, the label pop-up will show you both values, the one coming from your hex file as well as from your DCM file. Note that values from the DCM file are only shown as physical values. The same also applies to curves as well as maps. With the additional information from your project files and calibration data files, you can also use EHANDBOOK Navigator to quickly inspect your data. Use the Search Proposals dialog to query any label of interest, and EHANDBOOK Navigator will show you the complete information from the A2L file as well as the calibration data in the attached label pop-up.